Hello there, I'm Jake Roper, brother, son, friend, to no one. If you've been a Dong fan for a while, you might remember a website we showed you called scaleofuniverse.com. It's a very neat interactive experience that shows you just how tiny and just how enormous things can get. And for more tiny and enormous dongs, well, here's some things you can do online now, guys. Let me ask you this. How many smoots tall are you? I am 1.07 smoots. Whoa, Jake, what even is a smoot? Thanks for asking. It's a hilarious measurement made up because of a man named Oliver R. Smoot. His fraternity pledge was to measure the length of the Harvard Bridge using his body, which was 5'7", or 1 smoot. And that would make the Empire State Building 260.4 smoots. This Google mapped route from LA to New York City, well, that's 2,645,044 smoots. The distance to the moon is 225,920,955 smoots. There are other strange measurements like a beard second, the length an average beard grows in a second. For example, I am 365,760,000 beard seconds tall. The CN Tower is 110,642,400,000 beard seconds. The Great Wall of China is 4,239,333,964,800,000 beard seconds. And this website allows you to convert smoots or beard seconds into other measurements and vice versa. A beard second is 5 nanometers, and World Science Festival has a great video that helps you gauge just how tiny a nanometer is. There are other ridiculous measurements out there too, like one called Warhol, based off of Andy Warhol's statement that everyone would be famous for 15 minutes. So if you're famous for 1 kilo Warhol, you'd be famous for 15,000 minutes. Good job. But what is the smallest measurement? Well, let's go back to scale of the universe. We start with a Planck length, a distance so tiny it's difficult to kind of wrap your head around. In fact, it is the smallest distance between two things before they are considered to be in the same exact location. An atom is about 48,261,724,457 Planck length. Now let's see how long you'd have to zoom out just to get to the size of a carbon atom. Again, it's difficult to comprehend things on this minute of a scale since we can't see them with our naked eye or even a clothed eye, which is, I guess, what glasses would be. So let's check out cell size and scale. We'll start off at a carbon atom. It's the smallest thing this site shows. Zooming out a bit, we'll pass some viruses, a human egg, a sperm cell, a grain of salt, a sesame seed, and now a coffee bean. Fun fact, a grain of salt is estimated to have around 1.2 quintillion atoms. That number looks like this, by the way. Now let's get back to scale of the universe. Hey, hey, there we are. Now let's keep zooming out and we'll see a T-Rex, which is big compared to people, but some dinosaur sizes might surprise you. This chart shows a 5'6" tall guy as compared to a bunch of them. What comes to mind when you hear Velociraptor? For me, it's those scary guys from Jurassic Park that can open doors and they eat Muldoon. Muldoon! But good news, they're roughly the size of a turkey, so what does that mean? Well, you could kick them really far. How far? I don't know. Probably into orbit, into the sun? Potentially. They also had feathers, so if we saw one today, we might just think it's a weird-looking, murderous bird. And on the other hand, when dinosaurs aren't busy being the size of turkeys, they can be pretty behemoth. The Brachiosaurus is the largest known dinosaur and could eat vegetation as high as 30 feet off the ground. And it is, to this day, the largest known land animal ever. And that's pretty big, but the largest animal to have ever lived is actually alive today. Do you know what it is? Leave a comment down below. Oh, it's a blue whale. Good work, you did it! And this site lets you get up close and personal with a blue whale. Now, blue whales, it's hard to... It's hard to fathom just how big they are. But let me give you some facts that might blow your mind, but they probably won't because you're very smart and attractive. They can weigh up to 181,437 kilograms. That's close to 500,000 pounds, almost as much as I can bench, ladies. Their tongues also can weigh as much as an elephant. An elephant! And their hearts, unlike my black hole, are around 204 kilograms, about the size of a car. The daily requirement of an adult blue whale is around 1.5 million calories. And now, let's say you eat an average of 2,000 calories a day. It would take over 2 years to eat what one blue whale eats in a single day. Challenge accepted. Now let's go back to scale the universe and zoom out a bit further. Okay, here we have Vatican City. It's the smallest country in the world. And now it's still bigger than myself or a blue whale or a Planck length. But as far as countries go, it's not very big. TheTrueSize.com is a really neat site that shows you, well, the true size of countries. When projecting a 3D globe onto a 2D map, there's room for errors and distortion. The most popular map projection that you're probably familiar with is the Mercator projection. It distorts the sizes of countries close to the poles. For example, Africa Africa and Greenland look to be about roughly the same size, but in reality, Africa is much larger than Greenland. Sorry, Greenland, you're still great and I love you. We are given three countries for comparison, the United States, India, and China. And look what happens when we drag the US over Africa. It pales in comparison. But now drag it up here and it becomes very clear that Africa and Greenland are nowhere near the same size. Let's wrap that map back into a globe and here is our beautiful Earth. It seems big and beautiful because for the most part, it's all we've ever experienced firsthand, so it's hard to conceptualize just how tiny it really is in the scope of the universe. But let's at least try, shall we? So, this is Earth, larger than Mars, Mercury, and Venus, but zoom out. And ho ho ho, holy moly, it looks pretty small. Now let's say you wanted to drive around the whole Earth, because why not? Well, it'd be close to a 40,233.6 kilometer trek, so all you have to do is just not sleep or go to the bathroom or go insane from claustrophobia. I mean, I guess you could sleep, because we're not timing you on how fast you go. Anyway. If you wanted to do it in one go, you'd have to keep a pace of 80.47 kilometers per hour, and you should get there in about 21 days with no breaks. But it would take you over 227 days of nonstop driving to get around all of Jupiter at the same speed. And other than a lack of patience, I see no reason why you couldn't do it. And remember, my dear child, no matter how many Warhols you are famous for, no matter how many smoots you are, stay humble. Because in the grand scheme of things, you are pretty tiny. Which is a beautiful thing, and is all, no. You know what? I'm not gonna say it. As always, thanks for watching just yet. Oh no, I just did it. Hello! Ha ha! Go, 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 go! The smallest thing, the shite. Scoot it! The smallest thing, this shite. Scoot it back. Yep. Scoot it back.
It's hard to fathom just how enormous these guys are, so I'll list off some facts and you can let me know if your mind is blown.
Jack, scoot it back, Jack. Jack, I'm too excited.
Oh!
Let's scoot. Scoot. Yeah. Scoot it back. Yeah, great. Got it. It's just my time you're wasting. Keep scooting. Scoot. Okay, that's good.